Do you ever look in the mirror and wish you had thousands of dollars to look more attractive? Let me share a secret. Being more attractive isn't about having a ton of money, the best looks, or your age. It's more than appearance. It's about your energy and being happy and confident from the inside. What you radiate outwardly comes from within. Hi, I'm Karen Fagan, and I've been empowering women for over a decade. And I want you to know you can be, do, or have anything your heart desires. I'm gonna show you 5 ways to look more attractive without spending thousands of dollars. Through this exercise, I'm gonna show you how to feel better, become better, and be more confident. I want you to know that you can look better by improving how you feel. And it comes down to a few simple things. One is being happy from within. 2, how well you take care of yourself. And 3, raising your standards. I want you to imagine this. You can take the same beautiful dress and put that dress on 2 different people. 1, a less attractive but happier woman. Or 2, a more attractive but unhappy, grumpy woman. Who do you think will stand out? Yes, 1. Step 1 to look more attractive is to invest in your self-care and do this daily. If you do or don't invest in your self-care, it shows. Yes, it's lovely to spend the day at the spa, but I want my confident ladies to invest in their self-care daily. Self-care happens in the morning, during the day, yes, while you work, and in the evening. It's not a once a week thing. When you make self-care a priority, it shows in the way you carry yourself. You feel and look better. You become more relaxed and open, and you have a glow, which is always attractive. You want to be and look like a well-kept woman. Let's face it, being stressed out, chaotic, uptight, and unkept doesn't make anyone feel or look more attractive. Here are some daily self-care tips. I want you to make the time to connect with yourself and your desires each day. I want you to exercise. This will help you feel happier and confident in your body. And I want you to take a shower and get dressed. Start your day being showered and dressed. Put your signature scent on and smell good. Ladies, personal hygiene matters. When you do this, you will feel fabulous and you'll be more productive, which will always make you feel confident about yourself. Not showering or wearing worn out, unfitted sweatpants, it's unattractive and it never makes you feel better. It lowers your energy. I want you to eat nutritious food and enjoy the food you eat. I want you to drink water. Hydration is good for your skin, your energy level, and great energy is always attractive. During the day, have boundaries with your time and your energy. This is self-care. Being all over the place is simply not attractive. At night, wash your face, rinse off from the day, put good smelling lotion on and clean sheets on your bed. Ladies, effort is attractive. And when you put effort into how you take care of yourself, it will show in all you do. Step 2 is to develop confidence in your body language. Body language is one of the most powerful forms of communication. Your body language communicates how you feel to the outside world. It can draw people to you or push people away. I want you to have awareness of your body language and develop greater confidence in your body language. Here are some tips for having confidence in your body language. Keep your head up. Don't look down when you're walking. The same for when you're talking with someone. Look at them, smile. Looking down or looking the other way isn't what I want my confident ladies to do. If this is challenging to do, start by looking at yourself in the mirror each day and smiling. Now, let's talk about your arms and hands. Uncross your arms. Take your hand off your hip. Keep your hands from playing with your hair or touching your face. Instead, relax your arms and hands. Have good posture when you stand, walk, and sit. Elongate your spine and roll your shoulders back. And remember to breathe. When you do this, you will feel more powerful and look confident. Ladies, pay attention to your facial expression. Do you have a resting bitch face? Look mad, upset, uptight? Or does your face express being relaxed and inviting? Step 3, drop the negativity, excuses, complaining, and gossiping. It is not attractive. Develop a positive attitude. Pay attention to your attitude. No one likes a Debbie Downer. Be aware of what you're saying when you're talking and listen to yourself as you speak. Are you talking too much to fill up the air? Or are you complaining? Or are you being positive, interesting, and lighthearted? I'm not talking about not sharing your challenges with your close friends or pretending everything is perfect. I am talking about enhancing your attitude and mood to be more attractive. Ladies, this is how you become the most attractive version of yourself. It does not include complaining, gossiping, or making excuses. This will never bring your life to the next level. Step 4, passion. Passionate women are attractive. Passion makes you interesting and intriguing to people. You radiate an alluring energy when you are passionate and it draws people in. When you are passionate, you are more excited and fun to be around. A woman who is passionate carries herself and speaks more confidently. Let's face it, being dull and boring is not attractive. Now, you can't fake passion. You want to connect to something that you love that lights you up. Here are my suggestions. If there is something you love to do, and for whatever reason you haven't done it in a long time, start to do it again. Make time for it. If you're not sure what you are passionate about, start to explore. Go to the art museum, try a new ethnic dish, go to a place that inspires you, and a new passion may come to you being there, or you may remember a passion you forgot. Investing in your personal growth can help you become passionate. Take a self-improvement class, attend a conference on a subject that interests you, or simply read a new book. Invest the time to find out what you love. It will be worth it. Step 5, raise your standards for what you allow from yourself. In this community, ladies, we have high standards for ourselves. I want you to have 5-star standards, like a 5-star luxury hotel, not a 3-star. Having high standards will increase the quality of your life. This will naturally increase your happiness. When you raise your standards, you are declaring what behaviors are acceptable and what behaviors you will no longer tolerate from yourself. When you elevate your standards to a higher level, you are demonstrating that you value you. And there is nothing more attractive than a woman who values herself and has high standards and doesn't accept less from herself. Here are 3 tips to help you start to raise your standards. Take the area of your life that you are most dissatisfied, one you would like to improve, or an area of your life you know you could do better. We all have one. For example, let's take your environment. Your home. Maybe you have piles of paper and clutter everywhere and it's been driving you crazy, but you haven't picked it up in weeks. Or maybe you have cabinets that are broken and they don't shut right. Raising your standards for your home environment would be to declare that having a messy environment is no longer acceptable. You would clear the clutter, fix the broken cabinets, and no longer tolerate a displeasing environment. Raising your standard for your home environment would be to declare that having a messy environment is no longer acceptable. You would clear the clutter, fix the broken cabinets, and no longer tolerate a displeasing environment. To elevate the quality of your home, you might want to freshen up and get beautiful scented candles or add weekly fresh flowers. I want you to comment below and tell me your favorite step. And if you want to raise your standards without spending thousands of dollars, click the link in my bio to join my masterclass.